summer storm appeared. Corky got afraid when it started to rain. Then we came upon a house. Should we go and fly?
Episode 20, Little Orphan Anna.
Oh, wow, am I hot? Sure wish the flying house had air conditioning.
I wish it had a refrigerator.
Oh, yeah. What I wish is that it was on its way home now.
Attention! Professor Humphrey Bumble requests your presence.
Huh? What's under that sheet, Professor?
I hope it's an ice cube.
Ta-da! Ladies and gentlemen, I've invited you here to witness the unveiling of my brilliant new brainchild.
Necessity is mother of invention.
Oh, what is it, Professor?
Come on, please, show us what it is.
Don't be shy.
3, 2, 1.
Lift off.
Some kind of heater.
Heater? In this weather? What for?
Possibly you could mistake it for a heater, but look! Behold!
Huh? It's cold. Freezing.
Precisely.
It's a refrigerator!
With all my ability, I found it very simple to convert this broken heater into the best refrigerator in Israel.
But why is it empty? Where's all the food?
Well, we're fresh out of food and almost out of money. Will you go shop and find some bargains?
Okay, I'll try.
Jerusalem hasn't changed a bit.
No, it's just as busy as always.
How much can you buy in Jerusalem for this little money?
I don't know. But that's all we've got. Look for what's on sale. Bargain.
Huh?
Stealing some fruit, weren't you? Weren't you?
No, my brother.
What happened?
Your brother was helping himself to the grapes without paying for them.
That's wrong, Corky. You'll have to give them back. Spit them out. Oh, no. Nothing but seeds.
You can't return the grapes. You'll have to buy this bunch here.
Oh. For how much?
Make it 10 pennies.
We can't pay it.
It's way too much because we've only got one.
Did you say one?
Mm-hmm.
Don't play dumb. I said you must pay me 10.
We would if we could.
All right, if you can't pay the money, I'll have to have your brother put in jail.
Huh? No!
No!
Please don't do that!
He's a baby!
He's a thief!
Hold on.
What? Oh, Santa.
Yes.
Quiet. What is it?
If these children owe you money, I'll be happy to pay for it. Please take it.
All right, makes no difference, just so I'm paid when I'm old. I hope you little brats appreciate what somebody did to help you.
Of course we do.
How can we thank you?
It was all my fault.
He made a mistake. But now he's sorry and he won't do it again.
No, I won't. I was hungry.
If you'd like some fresh fruits and vegetables, you can have all you want from my friend's farm.
You mean without paying for it?
Right. The farm belongs to a man named Harmon. And we're going to get married someday.
Wow.
We'll be happy to accept your offer.
Ah, fully.
Jojo, that melon's too big for you to lift.
All right, just you watch.
Jojo, be careful.
Got it. Sorry, we didn't mean it.
My name's Angie Roberts.
Hi, my name's Corky.
I'm Justin Casey, and I'm glad to meet you.
These children are my new friends. I met them at the market.
Hi.
They're all cleaned up.
Jojo, something tells me that you've been making trouble for your aunt again, young man.
No, I wasn't, Mother.
No, but I'm glad you came by, Abigail. Would you show my friends the farm and let them gather some vegetables?
It would be my pleasure.
Be your best friend if you let me show you. Come on.
We're coming.
This way.
Wait for Corky.
I'll see you back at the house, Jojo.
Bye. See, here's where we keep what's been picked.
Oh,
wow. I want some grapes.
Oh, I want some pears.
I want some of everything.
Yahoo!
Let's build a basket.
I'll take a dozen oranges.
A dozen? Justin, just because it's free, we don't want to be greedy.
Well, we were invited to take as much as we could carry. Right, Abigail?
Mm-hmm.
Positively. Fill your basket up, and my sister wants you to have this bag full as well.
Your sister's very kind.
She must be about the kindest person in all of Israel.
If it weren't for my sister's kindness, I don't know what would have become of us. When Jojo's father died, Anna brought us both here to live and gave me a job on the farm.
She's good to us.
Yes, and to all of the workers on the farm.
And us, too.
It's too bad that Master Harmon isn't more like her.
He's a bad guy?
Well...
If he isn't so nice, why is Anna marrying him?
I wish he wouldn't myself. Come on.
Where to?
Home. We're going to have lunch at Aunt Anna's place.
Wait for Corky, will you?
Anna lives with us in this big house. Because my aunt takes care of all the farm workers who live there, too.
When's your aunt plan to get married to Harmon?
Soon. Maybe sometime soon.
Wish we could be at the wedding. Won't she be a beautiful bride?
Well, hello there, children. Won't you come in and have some lunch with me?
Candy, yeah!
Hey! Wait for Justin!
Oh, Harmon's here.
Oh? Huh?
Hello, Harmon.
Well, hello, Anna. I see you have some guests.
I'm Justin.
I'm Angie.
Guests are always welcome on my farm here, because I'm very rich. Anna?
Yes?
Dear one, I've brought you a gift. Here.
Hmm.
Well, open it up.
All right.
Look! A ring!
Beautiful!
But...
My dear, plan on going along with me to visit the temple in the morning to hear Jesus.
Oh, can anyone go?
Of course, but it's going to be crowded, so get there early. Anna, why so quiet, sweetheart? What's the matter? Don't you like the present?
Of course I like it. Thank you, but I want to have a private talk this evening with you.
But I'm not going to be available this evening, I'm afraid.
Please.
Sorry. I have a dinner engagement, my dear, with some of my wealthy friends. Don't worry, we'll have our private talk some other time. Goodbye. Pleased to have met you all.
You upset?
Yes, I'm worried about Harmon.
Why?
Tell us about it.
See, he's changed. When we were young, both of us became orphans. My parents became ill and died. And his were taken off to be slaves. We had nobody to look after us, but he and I cared for each other. We shared what little we had. We loved each other very much. We still do. But Harmon hasn't kept our promise. You see, we made a pledge before the Lord that when we grew up, we would devote our lives to taking care of children who were orphans like us. So they wouldn't have to suffer like we did. But a few years ago, Harmon learned that he had a rich uncle who had passed away. His fortune was all left to Harmon. From then on, I've seen him change.
I see. After he got to be rich, money was all that he cared for.
He's always bragging about how rich he is.
Yes, I'm afraid you're right. Besides, he's forgotten about the dream we had.
For the orphan home? But that's what both of you promised.
Even though Harmon and I just made a childish pledge to one another, my belief is we also made a pledge to God himself. I just hope that Harmon's going to learn from Jesus that money's not all we live for.
Same here.
You sure you wouldn't be as bad if you had bags and bags of money of your own? I'd be surprised if you were even willing to give those vegetables to Jesus.
Hey, wait. Great idea. I'm willing.
Justin, what makes you be so generous all of a sudden?
This bag's getting heavy if you want the truth.
Ah, what a faker.
My, look at all this, Peter.
Yes, thank you, children. That's a fine present. It was very kind of you.
When you see Jesus, tell him the stuff's from us.
Peter, by the way, all of us want to come and hear Jesus preach at the temple tomorrow. Know what story we'll hear?
Maybe the master will talk about the gate to heaven tomorrow.
Heaven's gate? Where?
How do you find it?
Is it free? I hope it is. We're out of money.
That's all right. That won't keep you out.
To the richest man in town.
Ah, way to bring us some more expensive wine. There's nothing I can't afford. Even my ticket to heaven.
Commandments is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one.
I hear Jesus.
I can't see.
Pardon us, please.
Hey, Justin. What are they doing over there?
I don't know.
And the making contributions.
What for?
To show thankfulness to Heavenly Father.
We didn't know you're supposed to make a contribution.
What if you don't have any money?
Any valuable article is acceptable.
Here,
this is what I've got.
Corky, broken toys are not acceptable.
Why not? This is a valuable particle to me.
Look, there's Harmon.
Huh?
Hey, there comes Anna. Look!
Awesome!
Wow. Hi, Tim, Mother.
Look, Jojo.
Yes, with Abigail.
Jojo!
No, you mustn't interrupt.
Did you see that, Master?
Shameful. What do you say to that, Jesus?
I say to you that this poor widow has cast in more than all the others.
What? Some have given bags of gold, and she gave a few pennies.
They all gave out of their wealth, but she, out of her poverty, put in everything, all she had to live on.
But...
Am I right?
Yes, sir.
She what? Gave all she has to live on?
Ridiculous. Be practical, Master. I willingly contributed more gold than anyone, but not my profitable farm. Nor my trunk full of precious jewels and expensive clothes. Am I expected to contribute all of that?
That's not the point. We should all learn from what poor Abigail has done.
All my wealth, but the price is more than I'm willing to pay out. Come, let's go.
Oh, won't you please stay and listen to the words of the master?
Why should I?
Oh, Harmon, I beg you.
It's useless. He asks too much.
No Harmon, a lover's quarrel. Harmon, get it?
I prefer to enjoy this life right here on Earth instead of waiting until I'm in heaven.
Harmon, don't say such a thing, please.
Let's get married right away, and I'll buy some more property and build a fine new house. All for you, because I love you.
Please, listen. No, Please, that's not what I want at all, Harmon.
All right, I'll buy you whatever it is you want.
Have you forgotten what you promised?
Promised?
When you were a little boy, you promised before God to build a home for orphans.
Oh, my goodness.
Ha! Well?
What a good memory. We sure had a bad time back then. All the more reason why now I want to give you beautiful robes and jewels to make up for what you didn't have in your childhood.
But I don't want beautiful jewels or anything money can buy. I want to have our dream. The one you promised.
What's so important about that dream? I've got much bigger ones now.
Like what?
For instance, we'll have a fabulous party to celebrate our engagement and invite everybody in Jerusalem to come to it. I'll make arrangements for it.
No, wait.
Go home. I'll see you there later.
Good, especially because it's cold. That sub-refrigerator I constructed. Right, everybody? Don't you want to eat?
No, I'm too busy worrying about Anna.
She was the lady who gave the watermelons to you?
I'm afraid that she and her fiancé had a falling out.
So that's it.
I'm going to see her. Bye.
I'm coming too! Wait!
Find out if she's got more watermelons. Delicious.
Not here.
Justin!
She's packed her bag. Wait for us, Anna!
Hi, Anna! It's us!
Hello! Excuse me, but are you going away somewhere?
Abigail told me about a new orphanage in Jericho, which is badly in need of helpers. So I'm leaving to go there and work for them.
Really? What about Harmon, though?
I wish I could have persuaded Harmon to come along, but since I couldn't, I'll have to do it on my own.
Won't he miss you?
Perhaps. I know I'll miss him, but I must try to forget him. That's why I want you to take this, Angie.
Oh!
When we were children, Harmon and I ate from this together, but now it just reminds me of how he's broken our promise.
Thank you, but I can't accept it.
Please, you'll be doing me a favor if you take it.
You really plan to leave right now?
Yes.
Hey, Anna!
Oh, Jojo!
Anna! I don't want you to go.
I am surprised. I thought you were too big to cry, right? Come on now.
But you're leaving. We'll miss you.
Look, Jojo, I'm going to send for you and your mother just as soon as I'm settled there, so it won't be very long before we'll all be together again, just like we've always been. You promise me that you'll take good care of your mother and be a good boy. Be your best friend. Well, children, if you should ever travel to the town of Jericho, I hope you'll look us up.
Sure.
Sure.
Bye.
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 Take good care of yourself. Don't forget to write us! I love you, Anna!
She's terrific! Very brave!
Oh, Anna. Where are you, darling Anna? Huh? What's this? Ah, hello, children. What are you doing here this time of night?
Waiting for you to tell you that Anna left here.
Huh? What do you mean?
She left for good. She packed her bag and set off for Jericho because she wanted to work in an orphanage there.
Why would she do that?
Because she was determined that she would keep the promise she made to you once.
What a fool she was. When she could stay here and become my wife and have anything that money could buy, she preferred orphans.
Boy, did you ever miss a whole point? Because she doesn't prefer orphans. She just wants to be faithful to God. Angie, what's wrong? Let's go.
I refuse to believe it.
Believe it?
I refuse to believe that they can't get together when Harmon's still in love with Anna and Anna's still in love with Harmon.
Harmon's a first-class numbskull.
Well, I don't believe it. She loves him.
Where are you going? Hey, wait for me.
deserted for those orphans. Ridiculous. Someone's here. Come out, I say, Jojo. So it was you. What do you want here?
Well, I miss my Auntie Anna very much. She left because of you. Bring her back.
Oh, yeah? Well, I miss her myself, but nothing can bring her back. Nothing. Promise I made in my childhood.
To help other orphans like we were.
Oh, Anna.
Ah, I'm full. You kids are eating like pigs. Slow down.
Professor, have you forgotten? We haven't eaten since yesterday.
This was worth waiting for.
Justin, Andy, Corky.
Hey, Jojo!
Jojo, what happened?
Somebody contributed a chunk to the temple. Like this. A great big chunk full of jewels and money and expensive clothes.
Do you think it was Harmon?
Right. That's who it was.
Awesome.
Terrific. Harmon said to tell you goodbye because he's on his way to Jericho to join Anna.
To be honest with you, Anna, you were right. I haven't felt this happy in years or closer to God. Wait for me, Anna. I'm coming to fulfill my promise.
Justin, do you still think Harmon's thick-headed?
Not anymore, he isn't.